Hello, Waswere here, back with another video, and today we are talking about Magma Tempest, the newly released mage ability. I think that this is the most powerful ability ever released by Jagex. It's got everything going for it. But let's start with the ability description. It creates a 5x5 damaging area centered at a target or a selected tile. Deal 5 to 25% ability damage every 1.2 seconds over 9.6 seconds, and it damages up to 25 targets in the same area, with Revolution not triggering this ability. So over the course of the ability, it'll deal 8 hits of 5 to 25% ability damage, or 40 to 200% ability damage, which already sounds good. But the damage formula has a secret little addition to it for non-bleed abilities. For every boosted level that you have, you get 4 to 8 extra damage, which normally is pretty inconsequential, as all non-bleed abilities hit pretty high, but this one just hits particularly low. With our plus 21 stats from Elder Overloads, we're getting about an extra 100 more per hit from just the potion boost, making it even more damaging. In terms of basic abilities, the following average damage can be calculated. Big shout out to GameDelf, who has done all this math in PVME. I've left a link to the spreadsheet in the description of the video, so you can change things around as it suits your setup. Below are the average damages of most basic abilities with max mage gear. In terms of single target DPS, Magma Tempest is the second most damaging basic behind Greater Concentrated Blast. Basically, whenever you have a two-handed staff equipped and Magma Tempest is off cooldown, you should be using it. The ability damage rank doesn't change much for when Sunshine is up, except that bleeds get knocked lower. It's actually kind of funny because bleeds do less damage in Sunshine because of the fact that you lose the 10% damage buff from Maniacal while Sunshine is active. Now that we know that Magma Tempest is very good in terms of pure raw single target damage, let's talk about its synergies. First of all, small hits. This is probably the worst of the four synergies I'm going to talk about, but in the majority of PVM, multiple small hits are better than one larger hit of the same value. This is because Soul Split has diminishing returns. Hits above 2k heal for a smaller percentage, and hits above 4k heal for an even lower percentage. As an example, an 8k hit heals for a total of 350, but 8 smaller hits of 1k heal for 800 total, more than double. The only downside is the new soaking that was added in for the new Harrakhan fight in the Zuck fight, which seems to reduce the first X amount of damage, so small hits are much worse there. Finally, you can build up your Reaper stacks very quickly, getting to the plus 3% hit chance. At this point, it doesn't seem to add Exsanguinate or Incite Fear stacks, but I'm unsure if it's a bug or this is intended. Second of all, it's an AoE ability. In any situation where you're dealing with two mobs in a 5x5 area, Magma Tempest is going to shoot up to number one priority ability above Greater Conk, as there is no diminishing returns for multiple targets. Unlike with Corruption Shot, where the non-main target takes less damage as it's chaining to them. There's a max target amount of 25, but I imagine that we'll never reach that amount. I found Magma Tempest incredibly useful for the new caves, as a lot of the waves you can stack 2 to 3 enemies in the 5x5 range and just go to town. My first run with Magma Tempest went from 45 minutes to 41 minutes, a 4 minute improvement, and I was still learning how to use the ability. I've switched to a Ripper Demon and gotten all the way down to 33 minutes, and I think it's basically all Magma Tempest that has improved my time. Next up, we're going to be talking about its interactions with Tsunami. As mentioned above, Magma Tempest is not a bleed ability. That means it can and will critical hit, and that means it's very good with Tsunami. Each critical hit while Tsunami is up gives you 10% adrenaline, and we can stack crit modifiers together to make crits more common. Grimoire adds 12%, Biting 4 at level 20 adds 8.8%, and Reaver's Ring adds another 5% for a total of 25.8% force crit chance. 5% of the remaining hits will also crit, giving a total of 29.5% crit chance. There are 8 hits per target with Magma Tempest, giving us an average of 2.36 criticals per target, which leads to 23.6 extra adren gain per target on average. If you have all those crit buffs and 2 to 3 targets, you'll have so much adren that you won't know what to do with it. And last, we're going to talk about its interaction with the Staff of Armadil. The Staff of Armadil was already an insanely powerful weapon, but Magma Tempest just takes it over the top. How the staff works is that while the special attack is up, every time you land a critical hit on your main target, you get an auto attack released. This damage is based on the weapon you're wielding, so most people just camp two-hand staff to get the most damaging autos. All in all, once the recursive is done, you end up with an average of 3.35 two-hand autos per use of Magma Tempest while the staff spec is up. So let's summarize just how much damage and adrenaline you gain when Magma Tempest is used. when all of Sunshine, Tsunami, and the Staff of Armadale spec is active. Magma Tempest deals a base average damage of 10,563, gives 8% adrenaline as it's a basic ability, or up to 9% with Fury of the Small. It leads to an average of 3.35 critical hits, generating 33.5% extra adrenaline and 3.35 two-hand autos. Those 3.35 two-hand autos deal 12,063 damage on average, leading to a total damage of 22,627. So yeah, Magma Tempest does 22,672 damage and gives you 42.5% adrenaline on average. Did I mention it's a basic ability? Now let's go through the boss encounters and think of places where this is very good. It's good everywhere in your set DPS rotations, but some places have potential to make it even more broken. For the Fight Caves, Fight Kiln, and the new Zuck Caves, with a ton of trash mobs to deal with, you can easily trap 2-3 mobs in the area, combo it with Tsunami for near infinite adrenaline and those nice little Omni powers. Next, Angel of Death. During the third phase of Next AOD, there are 5 targets on the same square, and you're naturally going to have the Tsunami buff up due to the rotation. This means every 1.2 seconds when the hits go off, you'll have 5 hits of about 30% crit chance. That nets you so much adrenaline that you probably won't even be able to use it all. And then Virago on Scopulous Week. During phase 3 of Scop Week, Virago summons 2 minions that you stack on top of each other for AoE potential. In the past, people would 4-tick Blood Barrage spells or use Mechanized Chinchampas and Dark Bows. But Magma Tempest can do all of that for you. It wouldn't be a Waswere ability review video without talking about potential nerfs. I think it's just a little bit too strong. I really like the core concept of trying to trigger as many criticals as possible by not making it a bleed ability, and having it be 8 total small hits, but its overall damage is too high. There are 3 ways to nerf it. First, make the ability a threshold. This would make it rank behind Wild Magic, Detonate, Smoke Tendrils, and Asphyxiate for raw damage, making it only used when you have other synergies such as AoE Mob, Tsunami, or the Staff spec. Give it a longer cooldown. At 15 seconds, basically as the Magma Tempest runs out, you're ready to use it again. Giving it a 30 second cooldown would make people think about it more and try to save the ability for their Tsunami or Staff rotations and not just use it off cooldown. Nerf the base damage. This would do a similar thing as the first suggestion. If you cut the damage in half, then it's not a high priority basic and it's only used for those other synergies mentioned earlier. I hope Jagex keeps the main concept of the ability if they do touch it, kind of like what they did with Gricko, where they kept the main concept of a lot of hits to trigger bolt procs, but they just nerfed the raw damage of the ability. But that's the video. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something about Magma Tempest. If you did, leave a like on the video. It really helps me out and gets this video out to more people. But past that, have a good day, and I'll catch you on the next one.